You won't see him in front of the Sackett building. And you won't see him if you walk past Old Main. If you walk past the Willard building, you'll definitely see him.
This episode of Zone In focuses on the one and only
Willard Preacher.
And of course, we all know you can't get laid at Penn State. You're just not getting laid anywhere ever.
Yep.
In fact, you can't get laid at Penn State. Pretty good chance you won't even get laid when you get married.
My name is Gary Cattell, and I am the Willard Preacher. I started preaching here in November of 1982. I had become a Christian in August of 1982. And there was a person here before me by the name of Broco, and he was instrumental in my becoming Christian. I was searching for whether there was a God or not. And Broco was preaching out here at the time, and I would come out here and I would listen to him. And then I'd walk on and go to class or whatever, or not go to class or whatever I was doing. And sometimes I'd run into him on the street and we would talk, and sometimes I'd run into other Christians and we would talk. And eventually, I was walking down the street one time, and God chose to reveal himself to me. And he chose to reveal himself to me as the Christian God, and from that point on, I believe. Last day of the fall term in 1982, I got up and started to do it.
One thing you need to understand about yourself, you're not a good person.
You know, on the negative side, I've been slapped a couple times. It seems to be by lesbians for some reason. Faster when people actually get it and they become Christian. It would be nice, I guess, after I left, if somebody chose to do this. Not too many people want to dedicate their lives to doing something like this, but if somebody wanted to, that would be great.
I had a lot of classes in the Willard Building, so I heard a lot of his lectures. I also saw a lot of scenes and a lot of upset students, and I was one of them. The only thing I took away from everything he said was almost vulgar in content, and it always had to do with students misusing their genitals and women not respecting their vaginas and men not being responsible with their parts, and that's all I got from it. It wasn't done tastefully, and I believe everyone is entitled to their opinions, but you should be responsible about it, especially if you're trying to make an impact on young people.
Like right now, he's doing his bashing the students speech, talks about the girls and the guys, getting drunk, having sex. I've heard this one like how many times? Pretty much repeats it every week. But in general, I think instead of preaching, he just bashes students. I don't really get the point of that.
Yeah, I think he's a pretty interesting guy. From what I've heard, he's been here for like, 20 plus years. He preaches what he believes in, and in that aspect, I respect it.
I think that everything he says is ridiculous. Like 2 days ago, he told me that I was going to go to hell, so that was interesting. But at the same time, I think it's like part of Penn State now.
I don't think he's ever going to leave, because it's not right now. He's still out here preaching, and he does get a good amount of people actually coming out here to listen to him, so I think he's going to be here for a while.
Which brings us to one of the age-old questions at the hallowed steps of Willard Building.
I don't know any religion
doing it. Exactly what do the women here get out of the whole sex deal?